How is it going, everyone? I hope everyone is doing good. This video will be the first part of a new course, which is Web Application Penetration Testing for Absolute Beginners. This course should get you familiar with the fundamentals of web app security, web vulnerabilities and attacks, and will basically help you kickstart your web penetration testing journey. The entire course playlist should be around 20 videos, more or less, and it should cover firstly, the basics of how web apps function. Then I will show you the enumeration phase of a pen test. I will then teach you some known vulnerabilities that I think are crucial for you to know to get you started in the world of pen testing, which are, for example, XSS or cross-site scripting, SQL injections, misconfigurations in authentication authorization mechanisms, file-related attacks like local remote file inclusion, and file uploads. If you have no clue what I'm talking about, you don't have to worry, because you are here to learn, and I will do my best to explain all the concepts in the simplest way possible. All right, then let's get to it. So we're kicking off the journey with the fundamentals of web applications. In this video, we will be covering the basics of the HTTP protocol, the HTTP GET request, the headers, and finally, the fields in HTTP requests. So let us start by explaining what actually is the HTTP protocol, or even before that, let's explain what a protocol is. A protocol is like a set of rules that computers follow when they communicate with each other. It's a way for devices to understand and exchange information in a standardized way. Just like people follow certain etiquette when talking, computers use protocols to communicate effectively. For example, you would normally start your conversation with hi, and the other person says hi, and you would say how are you? The other person would respond with good, how about you, and so on. If for any reason you would decide to start the conversation with goodbye or see you later, the other person would be very confused. It goes the same way with computers, but it's even more strict, which means if you do not send the server the information that it is expecting to receive with the exact format, it would either not respond or respond with an error message or just behave in an unexpected way. So now that we know what a protocol is, let's move on to the HTTP protocol. Basically, HTTP is the backbone of communication on the internet. It controls how data is exchanged between your web browser and a web server. The principle is very simple. Let's say you're trying to access google.com. So you go to your browser, you type google.com. Your web browser will send an HTTP request to Google, and then Google's web server will send you back the response, which will result in you seeing the google.com web page. Okay, so far we discovered that we have two things in HTTP, a request and a response. Now let's look at the details of an HTTP request. Here is an example of a GET request. In this scenario, you can imagine that we typed in our browser's search bar the following address, example.com/example path?page=home and user=1. So that's what you type in the search bar. But here's what's happening in the background. This is what actually gets sent to the server, and under this exact format, in the first line, we have get/example path. The get that you're seeing in the first line is called the method or the verb. There are many HTTP methods that exist. We have get, post, delete, and others. But I couldn't bother looking up the rest of the methods when recording this video, but generally speaking, most of the time you will either find post or get as they are the most common methods. Get is usually used just to simply view the content of a page. For example, viewing the home page or your profile page or something like that. The post method, however, is usually used to send information. For example, if you're trying to log in into an application by filling a form with your username and password, then clicking submit. Or if you're trying to make some sort of update or change in information on the web application. The second thing is this /example path, which is called the URI. You have to understand the difference between a URL and a URI. The URL is the entire address, which is example.com/example path, and the URI is just /example path, page equals home, user equals 1. As part of the URI, we have the query parameters, which are in this case page and user, and the values of these parameters are home and 1. So how can you figure out where the parameters start? And how can we differentiate parameters? The parameters start after the question mark, and they are separated by ampersand symbols. So as you see in our example, the parameters start right here. Our first parameter is page. It has a value set to home, and our second parameter is user, and it has a value set to 1. Our next line is the host, and I think it's pretty clear that it is the server that you're trying to access. In our case, it's example.com. The following line is the user agent. The user agent indicates what type of browser are you using, or in some cases, what tool is trying to access the web page. So as you see in our case, it is set to Firefox on a Windows machine, which is understandable because I tried to access the website from a Windows machine using Firefox. This information is sometimes used by the server to in terms of making the web page responsive. So if the client is a mobile, you will see a different user agent and the appearance of the web page will be different. This sometimes can lead us into attacks, so keep that in mind. We'll ignore the rest of the lines for now, but the last term I want to mention in this GET request is the headers. All of these are called headers, and it is very important for you to know, so when we talk about a cookie header, you will most likely find something that looks like this. Since I do not want to make the video too long, I think we will stop here for now. The following video will be a continuation of the same chapter, which is also the fundamental concepts of web applications. So let's recap what we learned today. We understood what a protocol is. We looked at HTTP, which is the backbone of internet communication. We looked at HTTP GET requests. We also learned about URI and query parameters. And finally, the HTTP headers. So yeah, congrats. I hope you learned something new through this video. In the next video, we'll look at the POST request, the body of the HTTP request, and the HTTP response. I will leave that video right here in the end screen so you can watch it if you are interested. If you have any questions, feel free to ask in the comments. If you appreciate the content, take a moment to subscribe to the channel to stay updated and keep learning. And as always, happy pen testing.